business before the chamber is Model Senate 15. The chair recognizes Senator Lara, District 33.
Hi, I am Senator Elizabeth Lara, and I represent District 33. I will not deny that the issue at hand is of constitutional importance. It is. But with that being said, I oppose this bill for one major factor, time. There is no excuse for not wanting to redistrict and do it in an independent way. Deciding to recreate the redistricting process in the next decade only shows us one thing, that we are fearful. Let's not be fearful. Let's find a way to effectively and adequately represent the people that have voted you in to represent them, the people that you, each and every one of you, are accounted for. New York State has changed drastically in the last decade. Are we gonna throw that information away? No. We need to act, and we need to do it now. Thank you.
We're calling for a request vote. We need a senator to call the question, please. Senator Cologne.
I request a vote on MS Bill 15.
Thank you, Senator. The Model Senate will now proceed with a slow roll call on MS 15. The clerks will call the roll alphabetically.
Senator Altieri, District
32.
Fellow senators, we have an obligation to the citizens we represent to put forth policies which are in their best interest in an appropriate and timely manner. The proposed bill is inadequate. Not only would it take a decade to fully implement, it fails to guarantee that redistricting would even take place. We can do better, and the people of the great state of New York deserve more. We should use the information we have gained from the census while it is still relevant. I support truly independent redistricting, and I do not see that in the resolution before us. There are three Democrats for every one Republican in our state. Do the math. That ratio is not reflected in this chamber. Let us seize the opportunity to achieve the greatest good. Thank you.
Senator Hutchinson, District 54.
My colleagues, I have listened carefully to the debate and vote yay on MS 15.
Senator Octavia, District 46. Senator Anderson, District 46.
We all believe this nonpartisan redrawing of the districts will mean a great deal to all New Yorkers. This will ensure proper representation of the people that live within these lines. Unfortunately, every 10 years, the leaders of the majority in each legislative chamber draws out lines for their members and then passes it down to the governor, who then signs it or vetoes it. For the party of the majority, this is an advantage to draw oddly shaped districts such as 49 and 51. For the 2010 census, over 2 million people were accounted for in the wrong places. As senators, we need to work at advocating and securing the needs and resources of those we represent, instead of creating conflict between parties and losing sight of our duty, which is to be the voices of our people. Let us remove ourselves from these positions right now and get back into the shoes of civilians. We need to think long term with the changing demographics of the state, but at the same time, we cannot have our people wait any longer, like 10 years. And therefore, I vote nay.
Fed up with the accusation that are being made by some of the senators present here. I heard Senate Democrats accuse my fellow Senate Republicans for a lack of commitment to our honor, to honor our pledge to pass a much needed reform. However, it is not that we aren't supporting our pledge and our support for a need to redistrict. I'm still committed to some type of non-partisan redistricting. I keep hearing fair and independent. Well, there are a lot of issues that go along with those words. We want to do fair redistricting where all parts of the sum total are fair. For these reasons, I vote yea for the MS-15 bill, and I urge the Democrats, senators, to join me and my fellow Republicans to do the right thing.
If we're relinquishing our duties as senators, then we'll move to an independent commission we should do it by the Constitution. It will give us time to work the details and put together the commissions that our constituents deserve. Our constituents are worthy of change. I vote yes for the amendment. It was a team vote.
Senator Bukhari, District 14. Good afternoon, honorable senators. I believe that we should follow the dictate of principle, not motive of politics. Therefore, I vote against this bill because we must use the 2010 census data to redraw our district now. This will help the state to fairly allocate resources and place them where they belong. Honorable senators, if we believe that our duty is to serve the people of the city and the state of New York who sent us here to this chamber, we should not wait another 10 years. We need to improve things right now. As our President Barack Obama said in his State of the Union speech, overcoming the challenges we face today require a new vision for tomorrow. We will move forward together, or not all. It is the need of the people of the New York State we must work to attend to. Therefore, even my colleagues in the Republican district must feel an obligation to the people of the state of New York. I ask all of you senators to vote no on this bill. Thank you.
Senator Brathwaite, District 50.
Fellow senators, we showed the nation that this current session of New York government isn't broken by passing the budget on time and ahead of schedule. Yes, the power of mapmakers is apparent, but we are not the initiators or inventors of gerrymandering. I stand here in this chamber to support reform. Last year, I promised my constituents that reform was needed and that we as senators will bring it to them. The two Democratic bills violate the Constitution because as it stands now, redistricting is through legislation only. And by creating an independent committee without amendment, violates the Constitution. Rushing this decision sets a precedent for future legislation that would also see fit to amend the Constitution when thought necessary. This democratic process takes time. To make a temporary fix against the Constitution would violate the fundamentals of democracy. That is why I support MS-15. That is the only alternative to protecting our constituents, true representation. Thank you.
Change our state for the better. We are all here for a short time. Let's do a good thing with the time we have left. Do the thing that you want to be remembered by. Thank you. God bless America.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Senator Joel Cabrera, representing District 16, and I vote nay to this bill. The proposed amendments to this Constitution does not propose a change to the limit of population deviation in the drawing of district lines. In my district, there lives approximately 317,000 people, whereas in some districts upstate, the population is around 280,000. This is a population deviation about 40,000 people. I advocate constitutional change, but I also advocate for change now instead of waiting 10 years. In order to have more equal and just representation of the New York State Senate and its constitution constituents, I favor a population deviation of at most 0.1%, which this bill does not address. I recognize the effort to change this flawed system for the better. But again, I vote nay and advocate for a maximum population variance of 0.1% in the drawing of district lines. Thank you.
Senator Sal, District 25.
Good afternoon. Although redistricting my constitution is a good solution, it takes too long to get the job done. Therefore, I vote no for this bill. Redistricting is like a long assignment. That's the deadline next month. Let me show that. And we have to get it done no matter what. So would you rather start doing it right now or just postpone it? One of the advantages of doing redistricting right now is that if it doesn't work well, we, all of us, can still have time to get it done by the Constitution in the future. And before we take our vote, I hope you remember that we are not only Democrat or Republican senator, we are senator of New York State as a whole. And New York State is like a body that can only function well if all parts are being taken care of adequately. It's never yours or mine. It's our district, our state, and our country. Thanks.
I'm Senator Emmanuel Kaplan, and for the interest of all New York State, I vote yay for this bill. Say no to this bill. Thank you.
Sipu, District 11.
Honorable Senators, this bill has great intentions behind their proposal to make each district more equal. However, we should vote on the basis of facts, not narrow ideology. Therefore, we should defeat this bill because the steps that they are going to have to take to pass this bill are too extensive and are going to take too long to pass. As the Democratic Senator of the 11th District, I know that the MS-15 bill will hurt, not help, the constituents of my district. How, you may ask? If we redistrict our state based on the framework of having no more than 5% variance of each district, this regulation has a risk of not representing the whole constituent body. As the distinguished Senator Galindez mentioned, not representing the whole constituent body will, and not considering the population will indeed violate the Equal Protection Clause of the 14th Amendment. This is why I dissent and vote nay on the adoption of this bill. Thank you.
Senator Crawford, District 57.
Good afternoon, everybody. I agree with the Senate Democrats on one thing, that a redistricting reform is necessary. However, the only legal way to change this redistricting process is through a constitutional amendment. I question the inconsistency of certain Senate Democrats, along with the lack of support for their own government, failure to take responsibility for the actions they've created, and their inconsistency. Están votando por el interés en this, in, sorry. De su distrito o por el interés en sí mismo. I vote yay for MS-15.
Good afternoon, fellow senators. I understand and agree that there is a need for redistricting reform. I know we all need to work together to restore faith, the trust, and the confidence back into the state government. But it does not mean that we sign on a bill that does not address all of the concerns and needs of redistricting. Yes, let's push forth with a redistricting reform, but let's do it the right way. Therefore, I vote yay to bill MS-15. I ask you to stand beside me and vote yay too. Thank you.
Therefore, we will protect their future generations by fairly distributing resources to all citizens of New York State. I vote yes to MS-15.
Senator Esprit, District 39.
Will be overriding the separation of powers. As a result, his bill
not be overriding that of the Constitution, and we shall stand against it. Thus, Governor Cuomo, Andrew Cuomo's bill will be just as messy, if not unfair, and unfair to the constituents of the state of New York. This is why I vote here.
I believe that what it has to offer is wrong, but because I don't like the manner by which it was introduced. This bill was introduced by Republicans, the same Republicans that, according to the press, signed the New York Uprising Pledge when they were in the minority and when they wanted to get elected. Now that they have accomplished their goal, they are stalling by introducing this bill. If I were to support this bill, then I would become a liar and a dishonest man, because by signing this pledge, I agree to its mission, which reads, it is our common desire to improve New York State government and the democratic process in the state by ensuring that redistricting pursuant to the 2010 census be constitutional and fair. As we can see, it refers to the 2010 census and not the 2021, which is when redistricting will occur if we pass this bill. With that said, I urge my colleagues to rethink their decision and to join me in honoring our pledge. If you do, not only will you gain more trust from your own constituents for being honest and keeping your word, but you will also gain respect from your colleagues and other constituents, because a pure soul will always praise and acknowledge what is morally right. Thank you.
Senator Foster, District 22.
Permanent and right solution through the Constitution will deal with gerrymandering for the future. Therefore, Senator Melendez, slow down. Therefore, I vote yay on the bill.
Senator Fuentes, District 53.
Honorable ladies and gentlemen of the Senate, I'm here today to speak in a matter of great importance. In regards to Bill MS-15, I am voting yes, because it is our obligation to deal honestly and earnestly with the people of the state of New York. If we really hope to represent the people in each of our communities, we have to establish a new way to redistrict our state. But unlike the typical Democrat, I believe that a short-term solution will be ineffective. We need to deal with this incredibly important issue by amending the Constitution. I understand that desperate times sometimes call for desperate measures. However, desperation in the body of this assembly does not do justice to our responsibilities, not only to my constituents in District 53, but also to every citizen of the state of Georgia. I love our state, I love my district, and I intend on fighting to the bone to see a new way of redistricting our state implemented into our state constitution. Join me and do the same. I vote yay for the MS-15 bill. Thank you.
Senator Garcia, District 4.
Senator Garcia, Long Island District 4. Good afternoon, fellow senators and distinguished guests. I, Senator Garcia, rise in support of the MS-15 bill as the most effective action to be taken and the only one that should be considered by both parties on the aisle. Consider that SM-115, a bill that will address redistricting by the principles of fairness and effectiveness. I hear my colleagues on the other side talking about being fair, and they're so concerned, but I ask them, why, when you were majority of the Senate, why didn't you address that issue in that time? Back then, you were more concerned about your political interests. So I urge to all my fellow senators to vote for MS-15. Let's do the right thing, let's do it properly, and let's go with the Constitution. I, Senator Garcia, vote yet on MS-15. Thank you.
Senator Gutierrez, District 37.
I am Senator Gutierrez. I represent District 37. I strongly disagree with the MS-15 bill, because this bill does not keep our 2010 campaign promises. Let me explain this. 60 out of 62 senators sitting in this chamber right now pledge, 60 out of the 62, not including Democrats and all Republicans, voted on the pledge. Okay. This pledge was to reform Albany, like Senator or Colin Colon said. Now, an example of that, of this bill contradicts everything that we pledged for. 60 out of 62, once again. An example of that contradiction, going back to Colon's earlier speech, where it was mentioned that the MS-15 will reform Albany. Let me ask you, did you forget what the pledge says? Let me just remind you. What we have signed in this paper, it is in our common desire by ensuring the redistricting pursuing the 2010 census to be constitutional and fair. 2010, not 2020, not tomorrow, just today. That is why I will encourage my colleagues and 60 senators, Democrats and Republicans, who sign on the pledge to vote nay on this bill. Thank you.
Fellow senators, I am Senator Tim, representing District 18. As we know, our redistricting that allows gerrymandering is not ethically right and is not fair. It is a shame in this state. We have to change it. I will vote against the bill because it takes too much time. If we pass the bill, it will affect 2022 redistricting, not 2012. We do not have to waste such time. We should stop this shameful redistricting. So I urge you to vote nay, so we can change it now. Thank you.
Good afternoon, fellow senators. I am committed to the interests of the constituents in my district and to those of New York State. I am also committed to a redistricting reform that is transparent, fair, and equal. Bill MS-15 does not ensure that. We need a district reform now. Let's stop wasting time and making excuses. We cannot afford to wait. Our constituents cannot afford to wait. It's hard for me to understand how 1 year ago, many of my fellow Republican senators signed a pledge promising to make a reform, but now does not see urgency in implementing a redistricting reform. So much for signing that pledge. Come on, show our constituents that we want to change. Let's keep our word. Therefore, I vote nay to Bill MS-15.
Take a look
at District 27.